But in terms of anagrams, this isn't an anagram, it's actually a limerick composed by someone, which I invite you to recite to me.
Oh.
See if you can.
Huh?
Yes. Oh. That's a shock, isn't it?
Yes.
And you can do it.
Can you?
Yep.
Yes, you can. It is a limerick.
Okay.
Okay. Right. You have to ask yourself what these numbers are, in fact. They have some other...
A dozen and 12 dozen.
Ah! We're 12, but 144 is also called a...
Gross.
Just keep
so,
just
a dozen a gross, a score,
gross
plus three
amazing.
Times the square root of four, divided by seven. You're right, so you're doing well. Plus 5.0. Calm down. Do I have to slap you?
The episode of QI where Stephen just slapped.
So say it again as a limerick. You can do it now.
Yes, yes.
Go on.
Go on then, Susan.
A dozen, a gross, and a score, plus three times the square root of four, divided by seven, plus five times 11,
equals nine squared, plus not a bit more.
There you are. Well done. It was a guy called Lee Mercer who came up with that. It's rather good. 12 plus 1
yes.
equals 11 plus 2?
It does.
Yeah, but in what other ways does 12 plus 1 equals 11 plus 2?
Oh, is it an anagram then?
They're anagrams of each other. 12 plus 1 written out is an anagram of 11 plus 2.
Wow, you really have had too much time on your hands.
These were worked out by Nelson Mandela and Robin Island.
I think they're rather fabulous.
They
so
are. Right.
There.
They're marked.
Let's look back at the ones that we've got left in our number cloud. 142,857. If I tell you it's a cyclic number, does that mean anything to you?
No, is it to do with bicycles?
Oh, I like that. How many bicycles in Paris, that kind of thing. Yeah, no. So if you take this number and you multiply it by any number between 1 and 6, the answer will always be an anagram of the original number. So it'll just keep all those numbers. So look there, times 2, times 3,
noise.
Times 4. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then...
We don't understand, but we're going to make... This is the beginnings of subjugation. This number is an anagram of the other numbers. Oh, number.
Let's have a look at the number 43. Anybody know about the number 43?
What I say my age is.
Just joking.
Are you
older or younger?
I'm older, yes.
See, I was being polite.
Yes, thank you.
Boys don't mind about their age. Do boys mind about their age?
Oh, they pretend that they... Oh, you're shaking your head.
I don't mind about my age.
I don't mind about mine, so...
I'm 38 and proud. Nothing wrong with that.
Well, I have no idea. A year older than me, so... it's a Frobenius number. Not helping, am I?
No.
They didn't even give you a... Ooh.
So, I'm going to explain it in terms of McDonald's, okay?
Okay.
So this is a mathematical problem posed by a German called Ferdinand Frobenius in the early 20th century. Let's say it's chicken McNuggets, okay? They are only sold in multiples of 6, 9 and 20, okay? And 43 is the largest number of McNuggets it's impossible to buy. So you could get 41 because you could have 20 and 9 and 6 and 6. You could have 42 because you could have 4 lots of 9 and a 6. You could have 44 because you could have 4 lots of 6 and a 20. You cannot buy 43 McNuggets.
Not even...
You'd have to throw some away.
Right. Not even if you know Ronald McDonald.
No.
What does this prove? You may notice it's not written in usual... mathematical language.
Yes, it's not a message from Al Qaeda.
No, it's not. It's written in symbolic logic, if that's of any help to you. Ah.
Have you got something about the Portuguese coup starting in 75?
Not about that. Who was the great logician of the 20th century, the great British master of logic
Derek
and
Trotter.
Mathematics? Sorry? Derek Trotter. He was also a great campaigner against nuclear weapons.
It's Bertrand Russell.
Bertrand Russell, Lord Russell. There he is, Bertie Russell.
He wasn't a barrel of laughs, was he?
They say that his breath was not good. I mean, that's in the biographies of Keynes and his contemporaries. He had very bad breath. But he was a remarkable man. And he wrote Principia Mathematica, which was a book determined to reinvent maths, because set theory produced all kinds of paradoxes, which seemed to suggest that nothing could be proved or complete or consistent in mathematics, which was a huge shock. And so he had to set out to prove mathematics worked from the very first principle.
Very, very good at Sudoku.
He was oddly enough, he was said not to be that good at mental arithmetic, but. So, in order to prove mathematics from the very beginning, you have to establish the first principle of arithmetic, and that piece of symbolic logic was proving that 1 plus 1 equals 2.
It's a bit late, the 20th century, to prove that, I'd say.
A bit late.
We've got quite a lot riding by the 20th century yeah. on 1 plus 1 being 2, you know.
There
a lot
is.
Of, quite a lot of engineering happening, quite a complex yeah. international economy.
Oh, please.
If you find out that it doesn't equal 2, what do we do? Just burn everything. Because God knows anything could fall on our heads. Money, you might as well eat it. Forget civilization.
Well, there is a general thought that if the what were considered to be the sound foundations on which all mathematics rested were proved to be rocky, that it may mean that some of the ultimate answers of the universe will never be answered. But it's rather splendid to think you would give so much effort into proving
what
one
an
plus
extraordinary
one.
Achievement.
It I mean, is.
You just have to bring up his halitosis.
I know, that was silly of me, but I love
you
that.
Know, it comes great... to something where you think you've achieved that.
Imagine meeting him at a party.
Old Stinky yeah. Russell.
I met this bloke at a party, he stank. When I asked him what he did, he said he proved that 1 plus 1 equals 2.
Number two. Okay, so for this, I'm going to ask Aisling, please to channel Carol Vorderman for me, if you wouldn't
oh.
mind. So here is a pen. So you've got to hold it up so that everybody can see.
Yes.
So maybe Alan can help you with that.
Well, I think I'm all right.
No, I mean, oh. hold it up so that the audience can see what you're writing.
Oh, I see what
yes.
you mean.
Yes.
Oh. Thank God I got this big, strong man with me to carry this.
Gentleman wearing a t-shirt says love is something. Any random number, please? Just a single-digit number? It wasn't a difficult question. Was it? Not that many of them. Eight. Write that down, please.
Okay.
Just to warn you, you're going to write a three-digit number, and there's going to be quite a lot of numbers.
So, so... eight.
Oh, dear. Okay.
That's so, just me having a gentle laugh with you, Sandy.
I love it. There is, let's go right up the back, the first row at the very back, the blue shirt at the end.
Two.
Okay. There we go.
Squeaky.
Shut up, Debbie McGee.
Let's go over here, lady with a patterned top.
Seven.
827. Whoa. Okay. So what I want you to do now is reverse the digits underneath.
Oh, yes. Oh, but that's always going to be two in the middle.
Yeah, that's fine, that's fine. Keep
that's
going.
Still out down. Down.
It's
yeah.
not really complicated what I'm asking you to do.
Yes, yes, yes.
Could you now subtract the smaller number from the larger?
Right, yeah. Okay, so we're going to do this now. So we take eight from seven, just not possible. I think we all know that. Yes, so we're going to do...
Wow.
I mean, I'm in the arts, you see.
Yeah.
So...
Nine!
What? Stop saying no at me in German and tell me what the answer is. Nine!
Yeah, and then
this one comes down here,
again.
So three from nine.
Right.
God.
So I need to have three numbers, so put a zero now, please. So we have three numbers, OK. Now reverse those digits, please. Zero.
Always nine.
Nine. And nine. Please, could you add them together?
Oof. So, 18.
No. So... So nine and zero. Start again.
Oh.
Nine and zero is nine.
Nine
and nine is
18.
Eight. Carry one. So the answer is... OK, so we've come to 1089. OK, thank you very much. Wow, that was painful. Really painful. So, what was the number that we had? We had 1089. So, Noel, I'm going to pass you a copy of 1,342 QI Facts to leave you flabbergasted. Noel,
yes.
Could you, let's see, 1089, take the 10th word on page 89 and tell me what it is.
Yeah.
What is it?
French.
French. Here's the envelope that I did earlier, and there is the word French.
No!